In our previous video, we talked about the importance of environmental surveillance for monitoring pathogens. We also introduced you to the field aspects of the bag-mediated filtration system, or the BMFS, a novel method for environmental surveillance of pathogens. Using the BMFS, the sample passed through a ViroCap filter. When the water was filtered, viruses and bacteria were captured or adsorbed onto the ViroCap filter material. To recover viruses and bacteria from the ViroCap filter and evaluate the sample, the filter is eluted using a high pH, high protein beef extract solution, and the microbial organisms are collected in the eluate. The sample is then secondary concentrated by skimmed milk flocculation. After skimmed milk is added to the sample, viruses and bacteria form flocks while shaking. These can then be collected by centrifuging and resuspended in a small volume to increase the method sensitivity. This video introduces the BMFS elution and secondary concentration laboratory protocols. However, first, we have a few reminders. Before we start, it is important to remember that working with wastewater or potentially infectious materials presents a safety hazard. Technicians should be trained in biosafety practices. Please use personal protective equipment at all times, including a lab coat and gloves. If the sample contacts your gloves or lab coat, change them immediately. To protect your own safety and your sample's integrity, all work should be conducted in a certified Class II biosafety cabinet. You should wash your hands with soap and water whenever derobing or leaving the laboratory. Protecting the sample and laboratory from cross-contamination is imperative. Cross-contamination can be prevented by using good laboratory practices and proper exercise of sterile technique. Following a spill or contamination by the sample, the surface must be immediately disinfected with a primary disinfectant such as bleach, Vercon, or Oxivir. Now that we have reviewed biosafety techniques and ways to prevent cross-contamination, let's go over the steps necessary to prepare for elution. Prior to elution, prepare your eluent. This is a 1.5% beef extract solution with 0.05 molar glycine at a pH of 9.5. BD-BBL beef extract powder is the validated reagent brand for this protocol. Autoclave the freshly prepared beef extract eluent at 121 degrees Celsius. You can store the eluent at 4 degrees Celsius for up to 1 week, or at negative 20 degrees Celsius for 3 months. Next, prepare your 5% skimmed milk solution. Oxoid skimmed milk powder is the validated reagent brand for this protocol. The skimmed milk should be autoclaved at 110 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes. You can store the skimmed milk at 4 degrees Celsius for up to 3 days. This solution should not be frozen. Finally, ensure all necessary elution tubing and materials have been autoclaved at 121 degrees Celsius. An elution device is used to hold the filter and sample collection cup and to connect the bilge pump. The elution device stand can hold up to 2 filters at a single time. The elution device contains a variety of pieces, including a bilge pump for driving elution, a base plate for holding the filter stand and collection cup stand, tall legs for the filter stand, semicircular pieces for the filter stand, short legs for the collection cup stand, circular pieces for the collection cup stand, short, wide diameter tubing for eluent injection, very short, wide diameter tubing for connecting the filter to the collection cup, short, small diameter tubing for the filter air vent, long, small diameter tubing for the collection cup outlet, very long, small diameter tubing for connecting the collection cup to the bilge pump, 2 VacuGuard filters to prevent cross-contamination, a syringe for eluent injection, 2 C-clamps to secure the bilge pump, a collection cup for eluate collection, a collection cup lid with ports for connecting the collection cup to the filter. The Elution device base plate is shaped like a rounded trapezoid. The shorter side is the front, and the longer side is the back. To assemble the Elution device stand, take a tall leg, squeeze it near the bottom, and insert it into one of the six slots near the back. Some slight rocking back and forth may be necessary to insert the leg. Repeat this step for the other five tall legs. Insert the six short legs into the remaining front slots. Next, take one of the semicircular connectors and place it onto a set of three tall back legs with the opening facing the front. Repeat this step for the other semicircular connector, placing it on the other set of back legs. Insert the circular connectors into the two sets of short front legs. Your Elution device stand is now assembled. After filtration, the ViroCap filter is transported with cold packs to the laboratory for Elution. The sample should be eluted immediately. If Elution cannot be completed immediately, store the sample at 4 degrees Celsius for up to 7 days post-filtration. Prior to preparing the workspace and working with your sample, put on your personal protective equipment, including gloves and a lab coat. Remember, your safety is first. A bilge pump will drive the Elution process. Secure the bilge pump outside the biosafety cabinet using two C-clamps. The bilge pump is located outside the biosafety cabinet to prevent contamination. Disinfect the biosafety cabinet and surfaces using your lab's approved methods, such as Oxivir or Vircon, followed by UV. Line the biosafety cabinet with bench paper in case of any spills. You may then place the reagents and materials inside the biosafety cabinet, including 300 milliliters of sterile 1.5% beef extract with 0.05 molar glycine at a pH of 9.5. 50 milliliters of concentrated 5% bleach solution in a small beaker. 5 molar hydrochloric acid. 5 molar sodium hydroxide. pH strips with a range of 6.0 to 10.0. 1 syringe for eluate injection. A collection bottle with at least 300 milliliter capacity. This should be labeled with appropriate sample identification information. For example, include the filter ID, sampling location, date, and your initials. Tubing for the Elution device. VacuGuard filters to contain bioaerosols. A sterile collection cup with a modified lid fits inside the front circular support on the Elution device stand. The elbow port should face toward the filter stand. The collection cup will hold your eluate after elution. Connect the collection cup and the pump. Do this by attaching the long, small diameter tubing to the collection cup lid's straight outlet. To prevent aerosols from entering the pump, attach a VacuGuard filter to this tubing, with the inlet facing the collection cup. Finally, connect the very long, small diameter tubing to the bilge pump and the VacuGuard filter. Attach the very short, wide diameter tubing to the collection cup lid's elbow inlet. You are now ready to bring your sample into the biosafety cabinet. If any liquid remains inside the ViroCap filter, remove the filter's blacktop inlet cap and empty the liquid into the small beaker filled with bleach. Carefully remove the bottom black outlet cap and attach it to the tubing on the collection cup. Place the filter in the filter stand. Remove the white cap from the filter vent and attach the short, small diameter tubing and a VacuGuard filter. The VacuGuard inlet should face the ViroCap filter. This will help vent the filter when you inject the eluate and help prevent cross-contamination. Remove the black cap from the top filter inlet and attach the short, wide diameter tubing. Your setup should look like this, and you are now ready to elute your sample. Suction 150 milliliters of beef extract eluent into the syringe, making sure there are no air bubbles. Slowly inject the eluent through the injection tubing. As you slowly inject the beef extract, watch to ensure the liquid does not contact the VacuGuard filter. If the liquid does contaminate the VacuGuard filter, pause injection. The contaminated VacuGuard filter should be autoclaved and disposed of. Replace the VacuGuard filter with a new filter. If the ViroCap filter cavity completely fills with liquid prior to injection of the full 150 milliliters, stop injection and dispose of excess eluent into the bleach container. When eluent injection is complete, let the filter stand for 15 minutes to allow the organisms to desorb from the ViroCap filter. If you are eluting a second filter, set up your filter and collection cup and inject the eluent 7 minutes after eluent injection to the first filter. This will enable adequate time for pumping between samples. 15 minutes after eluent injection, you will recover the eluent in the collection cup. To do this, slowly and methodically pump the bilge pump until all eluent exits the filter. Do not pump with excessive force, as this may damage the bilge pump. Do not overfill the collection cup. If eluent enters the tubing connecting the collection cup to the bilge pump, stop pumping immediately. Empty the eluent into a separate bottle and continue pumping until all liquid has exited the filter. Note, a collection cup overflow is uncommon as the eluent from both elutions should fit in a single collection cup. Perform a second elution by injecting an additional 150 milliliters of fresh beef extract eluent, waiting 15 minutes and recovering in the collection cup. After elution is complete, carefully detach all tubing from the ViroCap filter, collection cup, and bilge pump. Place the tubing in a bag to autoclave, then wash the tubing for reuse. Remove the collection cup lid and carefully pour the eluent into the labeled collection bottle. Pause your cleanup here to immediately adjust the pH of the eluent to between 7.0 and 7.5 using hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide. This will enable your target organisms to be at a stable pH and increase survival. Add reagents in small increments and gently swirl the bottle with the lid on to mix. Check the pH using pH strips. Compare with the standard and discard the used pH strips in a biohazard bag. Note that pH adjustment has potential for cross-contamination. Only open one sample at a time and use sterile technique. Store the pH-adjusted sample at 4 degrees Celsius until secondary concentration. Continue your cleanup by discarding the collection cup and lid. Place the ViroCap filter in a biohazard bin for waste disposal. Sterilize the elution device stand by autoclaving. It can remain assembled or be disassembled for this process. Rinse the syringe with sterile distilled water 3 times. Wipe down the bilge pump handle with a primary disinfectant such as Vercon or Oxivir. After your biosafety cabinet is cleaned and the sample has been eluted and pH adjusted, you are ready for secondary concentration. As always, don your personal protective equipment, including a lab coat and gloves. Disinfect the biosafety cabinet using your lab's approved methods, such as Oxivir or Vercon, followed by UV. Line the biosafety cabinet with bench paper in case of any spills. Add the following items to your biosafety cabinet. Your 5% skimmed milk solution. 5 molar hydrochloric acid. 5 molar sodium hydroxide. 10 milliliters of sterile phosphate buffered saline at pH 7.4. pH strips with a range of 2.0 to 9.0. Parafilm. Pipette aid. 1 10 milliliter pipette. 6 50 milliliter conicals for centrifuging your sample. Finally, collect your sample from storage at 4 degrees Celsius. You are now ready to begin the skimmed milk flocculation secondary concentration procedure. Add 3 milliliters of skimmed milk to the sample. Adjust the sample to a pH between 3.0 and 4.0 using hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide. As with elution, add reagents in small increments and gently swirl the bottle to mix. Check the pH using pH strips and compare with the standard. Parafilm the sample bottle. Place the sample on a shaker at room temperature for 2 hours. Choose a speed that will get you a nice, even shake. This step is very important, as acidification coagulates the milk proteins, and viruses adsorb to these proteins to create flocs while shaking. After 2 hours has passed, remove the sample from the shaker and transfer the sample to conicals compatible with your centrifuge rotor. For this demonstration, we will transfer into 6 50-milliliter conicals. Spin the sample at 3,500 G at 4 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes. After centrifugation is complete, return the sample to the Biosafety cabinet. Discard the supernatant into the original sample bottle. Add 10 milliliters of sterile phosphate buffered saline to the pellet. If your sample is divided into multiple conicals, transfer the pellet between conicals so that all the pellets are resuspended into the same 10 milliliter volume. Parafilm the sample and vortex 5 to 10 minutes at maximum speed to completely resuspend the pellet. Congratulations! Secondary concentration is now complete. Store your sample at 4 degrees Celsius until you're ready for further processing. You may now proceed to purification by Vertrel or chloroform extraction, followed by assay using the World Health Organization Poliovirus Isolation Algorithm, RT-PCR, Next Generation Sequencing, TACMAN Array Cards, or other method. Thank you.